Hi, everyone. Aaron here for zollotech, and today Apple released iOS 13 Developer Beta 5. This came in at 564.7 megabytes on my iPhone XS Max, and it will vary depending on which device you have as far as its size is concerned. Now, let's take a look at the build number. You can see the build number is 17A5547D, and this particular build does not have a ton of changes in it, but Apple has said that there are bug fixes that they've resolved, and there's also known issues. So Apple has said in the notes there are 45 known issues, so there's still some bugs to fix. Before, with the first beta, there were more than double that, so they've come quite a long way, and they have until September to fix this. Now, they've also resolved 13 issues. So they've resolved things that have to do with not only bugs, but also apps crashing, such as WhatsApp and some banking apps as well. So that's great. Those things should be working for you. And also, if you're waiting for the public beta, it'll either be out later today or more likely the next day, or depending on when you're watching it, it could already be out. So be sure to take a look for that. Now let's talk about what's new. Now on my left, I have iOS 13 beta 4, and on my right, I have beta 5. And I wanted to show you a couple little changes. So if we go into shortcuts here, you'll see down at the bottom, they've actually removed this automation tab that they had on the previous beta. This would allow you to set up an NFC tag to sort of program what you want to do just by tapping your phone on an NFC tag. I really hope they bring this back. Maybe it's not ready. It didn't work 100% all of the time, so I think that's why they removed it. But right now, it's just not there. So hopefully they bring that back. Now, there's a few little changes here and there. One of the changes is to the volume HUD. Now, when you move volume up and down on the left here, there's actually some haptic feedback now. When you get all the way to the bottom or the top, you can feel the phone kind of shake a little bit. So that's something that's new. Not a huge change, but it's there. Now, also under the activity app, let's take a look at that. If we go under activity, there are some new move goals. So under the move goals here, down at the bottom, there is now 1,250. All the way up to 2000, and then there's perfect month. So before this, we only had up to 1000. Now we have up to 2000. So that's something that's new. Also, they've made some changes to the share sheet, and we're going to cover iPadOS at the end since there are a couple little changes as well. Now the share sheet itself is a little bit different, not hugely different, but let's take a look. Now, if we're on my website here, I'll do the same over here on the iPhone XR. You'll see on the left is the old share sheet, on the right is the new one. And you'll see the first thing is on the left, the font is blue, but on the new version for beta 5, the font is now black. The background is a little bit more translucent, and also they've now grouped the different sharing options into categories. So you'll see here we have copy at the top, down at the bottom, they're specific to Safari. And then we have some other things. We can also edit them at the bottom however we'd like, but you'll see it's grouped for Safari. So that's new, and that's really nice. I think the share sheet looks a little bit better now. Now, the final thing that's just tweaked slightly is the LTE signal. They've changed some of the actual sizes here. So you'll see the size of the signal. Maybe you can see it a little bit better here. It matches the size of everything else. So it's just increased in size to be consistent across the top with the battery and the Wi-Fi signal. So nothing major, but a little bit of a change. Now, one other thing they've changed before we take a look at iPadOS has to do with the app called Home. So if we go into Home, you'll see I have a bunch of different lights here. You can control those. But if we go to Edit here at the top, then tap the little button here, then I scroll down, we now have new wallpaper for Home. So we'll hit choose from existing, and you can see we have some new wallpaper at the top. Nothing phenomenal, but they will carry across to all of your different devices. So if I set that to blue, it takes a moment, it updates in the background, then it sets it on all of the different devices. Now, speaking of other devices, iPadOS has a couple little changes. One of those should make people very happy, and that has to do with the home screen grid layout. So if we go into settings, we'll wait for it to load. And this is an iPad Air 2, the oldest supported device. So we'll go into settings here, and then under display and brightness, if we scroll all the way down to the bottom, you'll see there's now app icon size. So we can make them bigger if we don't like them filled in as much. We'll wait for it to do its thing here. It's kind of slow on iPad Air 2 right now, but you'll see the icons are much bigger now. If I go back, I can make them smaller. We'll wait for it to resize, and now they're smaller again. So you have that option depending on how you want to set this up, and you'll see it's 6x5, and if we go back, It's 4x5 now instead of 6x5. So we have less icons, but they are larger. So however you like it, you can arrange it. Also, for the mouse pointer, they've made a little change. So if we go into our accessibility settings here, we'll wait for it to change. And like I said, it's pretty slow on iPad Air 2. Maybe it's just because I updated it, but I'm not sure. Let's go to, we'll go to touch. Assistive touch. And then down here, there's pointer devices. And pointer devices is nothing new. We can now use a mouse, but if we go to pointer style, we now have some different size options for the mouse. So there's a lot of other sizes, smaller sizes as well, and color. So you can change the pointer and things like that. So if you want to change the actual mouse pointer style, you can do that and its size. And that is really it as far as all the major little changes that we have in this update. Now, I would expect a lot of bug fixes. In fact, with this particular build number, we're on D. That means we're getting closer to A, which is usually the final release. And it may take a little while to see that. But right now, it seems like there's a lot of little bugs that they probably fixed and tweaked right now. And it's hard to say right off the bat because actually the last beta kind of slowed down over time. But hopefully it fixes the issues on iPad. This is the older iPad, so it's going to take some time to know that for sure. Now, I do have two other devices here. I have an iPhone SE, and it does seem to be working fine on the SE. So you'll see swiping is good. If I go into settings, settings seems to be nice and fast. No issues there. And then also, this is an iPhone 8 that I actually had repaired, if you remember that video. And it seems to be working fine as well. No issues whatsoever, although it is fairly new and it seems to be all right. However, battery life on the previous beta was okay, not great. I would expect it to get better over time. We'll wait for it here. Over the last 10 days, you'll see it's not amazing as far as 3 hours and 19 minutes of screen on time and 56 minutes of screen off time. That's not so great compared to the previous beta before that, but it is a beta. So I would expect it to get better over time. I really don't expect to have great battery life on betas. However, this one, hopefully it's getting a little bit better as we get closer to the final release, which is in September. Now, performance seems to be okay. Let's run a Geekbench on all of these just to give you a baseline to see how it's going overall for those of you that like to watch that. Geekbench benchmark has completed, and I'll just let you take a look at these, and I'll go over the XS Max. But on the far left, we have the iPad Air 2, then the iPhone SE, and then the iPhone 8. So let's take a look at the XS Max here. And I received a 4,836 for single core and 11,245 for multi-core. If we take a look at the history, it's actually pretty good. It's a little worse as far as the multi-core by just a little bit, and a little bit better on the single core. So that means basically it's going to be good overall. There's not a whole lot going on here. So that's really it for iOS 13 beta 5. Of course, if I find anything else, I'll let you know in a follow-up video. And if you find anything else, I'd love to hear what you have to say in the comments below. Of course, I'll link this wallpaper as I always do in the description below. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe and hit that notification bell if you'd like to see these videos as soon as they're released. And if you enjoyed this video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.